Okay, I'm going to do a little crawl-umentary, if you want to call it that. But anyways, yesterday I did a bunch of things to it. I had to fix the steering servo, so I replaced it with a Tactix. Got a nice metal servo horn now. And I was just going to kind of go over what I've done to this thing. Off with that, because I had to rewire it. I went ahead and just kind of just neaten things up in there, made it look more professional. Okay, and now on the battery, just a little hint on wait a minute, that's better. Okay, right here, these little ears. On this back ear, I put a screw in there, and I use a hard case battery. So you can put that screw down, just snug it down a little bit. That keeps the battery from, like, when you're climbing, it slides frontwards and backwards. That way you can put all your weight towards the front and hang on to it pretty good. One of the other things I tried was, if you notice, it looks kind of elongated for a Redcat, but see, it doesn't. You pick up one of these Redcats and they flop around, like, maybe that's why they call them cats, because they just flop everywhere. But I got that set up pretty solid, just the way it is. And I tried a lot of different things, but what I did here is, you can see I put the shocks all the way out to the end of the link here, where the rod and the link meet. And I did that all the way around. Now, I've lost some of my, if you're going across the top of a rock, I lost some of my bending flex. But it's got plenty of articulation. And if you compare it to the Losi, you can see that the linkages and everything are stretched pretty much the same. And this thing is solid as a rock. Very, very nice. Out of the two, I like the Losi better. But I do like the articulation in the Redcat and having the motors on the axles. So I'm trying to make this one work the best it can. So the other thing I did was down here on the bottom. Hello. This battery tray, these frames come down and then they go another space down. I cut that off and then drilled holes to match the battery tray. So that brought my center of gravity down even more. And that was a good thing. I learned it from somebody on YouTube. Another thing I learned was I made these like T-bars to try and keep the axles from flexing more than usual. That didn't work out. I'll probably take those off and put the originals back on. But it was worth a try. It worked on the guy's Losi. He did it. It worked real good for that. So the other thing was, I just said the shocks. Oh, and in my videos, the wheels were a big problem because you don't have much ground clearance. So these mudslingers, they're 2.2 mudslingers. This is a 1.9 growler. So these 2.2s are pretty much the same size as a 1.9. So I'll probably put these on when I'm crawling. That'll give me plenty of ground clearance, and that should help quite a bit. The other thing I noticed, I was watching the video, is the back end kept hanging up. So what I did is I went out in the garage and I made a little skid plate, and I bent it to shape so it matches, and I'm going to put that right on there. I think I'm just going to put it on with shoe goo. that stuff holds pretty good. And I'm going to go out and run the same course that I did yesterday using the bigger tires and the skid plate on it. And we'll just see what kind of difference I get out of it. See what the difference in the flex and all that turns out to be like. I think it should be better. I'm hoping so. So I'll see you, I guess, in the past, because no, we're in the past now. The next video will be the future. You'll already see it before you see this one. Kind of figure that out. Okay, we'll see you.